Native Object Store, NAS, enables you to analyze data stored in object stores like Amazon S3, Azure Blob Storage, AWS Gen 2 Storage, and Google Cloud Storage. With NAS, you can read CSV, Parquet, or JSON formatted data, as well as write data to an object store in Parquet format. For this video, we demonstrate how to write data from a relational table in the Vantage Analytics database to an Amazon S3 bucket using the write NAS operator. And we explore some of the options that determine how we want that data organized. Before we can write data out to our S3 bucket, we need to create a trust relationship with the database and the object store. To do this, we create an authorization object to securely store the credentials that allows us to read and write to our S3 bucket. In the first line of this statement, we see we are naming our authorization object WriteAuthNASS3. We set the user attribute to the access key ID for our S3 bucket where we're going to store our data, and the password to the access secret key. Let's run this statement. Now that we have an authorization object, we can reference it in our write NAS commands. So let's take a look at our first write NAS example. In the on clause of our write NAS statement, we're selecting the data from our source relational table, order 1600, which resides in a database called TRNGDS. This table has 1.6 million rows for orders with dates that span across 4 years from 10 locations. We can use write NAS to archive the older data from the year 2018 by filtering that year in the where clause. The primary index for our order 1600 table is the order ID column. This means that the rows are sorted across the amps in the row hash sequence based on the hash of the order ID value. Following our select statement, we see the words local order by. This option will allow us to sort the rows on the amp prior to invoking write NAS. Notice that we have set this option to location. This means that instead of writing our rows to the S3 bucket in row hash sequence of the order ID, each amp will first sort its rows by location and then write out the rows. In the using clause, we're setting three attributes: location, authorization, and stored as. In the first line of the using clause, we're specifying the location URI where we will store the data from our order 1600 table. Notice in the location attribute, we have a folder named orders_1600-v1 that follows the name of our S3 bucket, NAS Hands-On West 2 Training 33. In the second line, we're specifying the name of our authorization object we created earlier, WriteAuthNASS3. This authorization object includes the credentials that will allow us to write to the S3 bucket specified in the location attribute. And in the third line, we're setting the stored as attribute to Parquet. This means that the data that's written to the S3 bucket will be in Parquet format. Currently, Parquet is the only format allowed for write NAS. Let's run this statement. When we see the statement has completed successfully, we know that the data is now stored in our S3 bucket. The write NAS statement also returns an answer set, telling us what it has written to the S3 bucket. Now, the system we're using for this demonstration has 216 amps, and we see this answer set has 216 rows. Each row identifies one of the objects that the write NAS wrote to our S3 bucket, which means that records for each object came from one of our 216 amps. For each row, we see the node ID and AmpID, which stores the rows for the object, object name that identifies the URI of the object, and the object size and record count. If we hover our cursor over one of the object names, we can see the full name or URI of the object. Following the last slash in the object name, we see in this example, object 3301.parquet. 33 identifies the node, 0 identifies the amp, and 1 is a sequence number. If this amp had more than 16 megabytes of data, it would have created a second object whose sequence number would have been 2. After the sequence number, we see the dot parquet suffix. As you recall, in the location attribute of our write not statement, we specified a folder named orders 1600-v1 that follows the name of our S3 bucket. Following this folder name, we see /1/10. These values represent the codes for the location column that we specified in the local order by attribute. As you also recall, our order 1600 table has 10 distinct location codes. The /1/10 in the object name means that the records in this object include a range of location codes from 1 to 10. And the reason we see a range here is because that's the default behavior for the optional attribute called naming, which we'll see in our next example. Now, let's write out the same data, but this time include the naming option, discrete. In this write not statement, we're making only two changes. In the location attribute, we're changing the name of the folder to orders 1600-v2. We can't overwrite objects in an S3 bucket. So for demonstration purposes, instead of deleting our current set of objects, we'll just write the new ones to a different folder within our S3 bucket. We are also adding an attribute called naming in the using clause and setting it to discrete. This will cause the object name to include a discrete location code instead of a range of location codes as we saw in our previous write nos example. Let's run this statement. Now we see our write nos statement has returned an answer set with 2160 rows. Again, each row identifies one of the objects that the write nos wrote to our S3 bucket. This time, however, instead of each amp creating one object with records for all 10 locations, each amp created 10 objects, each containing records for just one location. And if we scroll through these rows, we can see the sequence values range from 1 to 10. Notice, too, that the answer set for this write nos has produced smaller object sizes, and fewer rows for each object because each one includes only rows for a single location. And if we look at the object name, we notice this time we don't see a range of location values. What we see is a discrete location value. So the value 10 here means that the records in this object are only from location 10's order. Now let's write out the same data, but this time let's add an additional attribute called #by. In this write nos statement, we're making only two changes. In the location attribute, we're changing the name of the folder to orders 1600v3, and we are also adding an option called #by and setting it to location. This will redistribute the rows across the amps by the row hash of the location column. After the distribution is complete, then write nos will write out the rows from each of the amps. Since we have 10 locations, no more than 10 amps will invoke the write nos. Let's run this statement. Now we see in our write NOS statement, we've returned an answer set with 10 rows. Again, there's one row for each object, and each one includes the records for just one of the 10 locations. If we look at all the rows returned in this answer set, we see the value of 1 in the sequence column in all rows except for the last one that has a value of 2. This means that AMP112 processed 2 object files. This happened because 2 of our location values hashed to the same AMP. Now that we've stored data in our Amazon S3 bucket, let's see how easy it is to access. In this read NOS query, we're going to return just 10% of the rows for a single location. You can learn more about read NOS in the microlearning called Exploring Data in an Object Store with the read NOS operator. Before we run this query, notice the where clause references the column named location 1 and not location. Let's run this query to see why. Our read NOS query has returned 4,775 rows. The first column returned is location, but this is not the location column from our source relational table order 1600. This location column identifies the URI of the object for this record. If we scroll horizontally through our answer set, we see the column location 1. This column's original name was location, but write NOS had to rename it to location 1 to resolve the naming conflict. For this video, we've demonstrated how to write data from a relational table in the Vantage Analytics database to an Amazon S3 bucket using the write NOS operator. And we explored some of the options that determine how we want that data organized.